Now question number 27 is, for alpha belongs to 0 to 3 by 2, define xn as n plus 1 to the power alpha minus n to the power alpha. We need to find this limit n tends to infinite xn. Now if the value of alpha is 1, then clearly in that case xn will be n plus 1 minus n, which is 1, and if we'll take this limit n tends to infinite, simply it'll be 1. Now when alpha is not equal to 1, then in that case we can write this xn as n to the power alpha 1 plus 1 upon n to the power alpha minus 1. We can write this as 1 plus alpha upon n alpha minus 1 upon factorial 2 1 upon n square and then minus 1. Now this 1 and 1 will cancel, so we can write this as limit n tends to infinite xn, and it will be limit n tends to infinite alpha into n to the power alpha minus 1 plus alpha minus 1 upon factorial 2 n to the power alpha minus 2. Now if alpha lies between 0 and 1, all these powers of n, they'll be simply 0. In that case, the value of this limit, it will be simply 0. But if alpha lies between 1 and 3 by 2, then this n, it will have a positive power. And when it'll have a positive power, then this xn will approach infinite. So answer to this limit will be 1, 0 or infinity, depending on the value of alpha. And that's your option D.